Hello. This short video explains how to create a part number for a Zetlex encoder and how to use the encoder product configurator. Okay, let's start with some basics. An encoder part number is made up of 7 individual elements. Each element refers to a particular product characteristic, such as mounting format, outer diameter, resolution, and so on. Simply select from the range of choices in each of the 7 elements, and you'll end up with exactly the right product for your project. So, we'll start from the first element on the left and work right. The first element refers to the mounting format. If you take a look at the relevant encoder product guide, either the mini, midi, or maxi size range, you'll see various mechanical formats described in drawings. Simply choose the format that best suits your project. You might also find the 3D CAD files on our website useful. You'll find these in the support part of our website. It's worth remembering that you can mix and match different mechanical formats of stator and rotor, but not sizes, and this can be reflected in the part number. For example, you can have a screw mount stator with a set screw rotor, and this will be referred to as an INC 7. INC 10 refers to a duplex arrangement, or 2 encoders in a single housing. These are mostly used for safety-related applications where there's a need for electrical redundancy. In our example, we'll pick the most common choice, which is INC 3, or screw mount stator and screw mount rotor. The next element's pretty straightforward. It's size, or specifically outer diameter. Watch out though, it's only a nominal size. You should check the product guide or 3D CAD files that actual dimensions are going to be right for you. There's a couple of details to note here. The duplex INC 10 format only starts at 125mm, and not all communications options are available in the MIDI and the maxi size ranges. In our example, we're going to pick 75mm. The next element is resolution. Resolution refers to the number of measurement steps over one revolution. 10 bits refers to 1024 steps. 11 bits refers to twice as many, 2048. 12 bits is twice as many again, 4096 steps, and so on. If you want the encoder to match an existing device with an AB pulse output, you can also specify the number of pulses per revolution. In our example, we're simply going to use 10 bits of resolution, or 1024 steps. The next element is perhaps the most involved, and it's communication interfaces, or comms. Life would be a lot simpler if all angle encoders just use one type of comms. But unfortunately, over the years, some very clever people have come up with lots of ways for angle encoders to spit out their data. The encoder range offers SSI, ASI, SPI, BIS-C, analog voltage and AB pulses. Synchronous serial interface, or SSI, is by far the most common choice for absolute encoders. And plain old SSI 1 is the most frequently chosen. Again, referring to the encoder product guide shows you all the necessary detail. ASI is similar to SSI, but there's no synchronization clock signal. SPI is serial peripheral interface, and it's widely used between encoders and microcontrollers. BIS-C is a fairly new form of communication interface, which is growing quickly, and it's very similar to SSI and is popular in the latest generation of motor controllers. AB pulses is mostly used for incremental encoders and motor drives. The analog voltage outputs of 0 to 5 or 0 to 10 volts are mainly used as replacements for potentiometers, usually in process control, test and development applications. If you're looking to match an encoder within a controller, you can check compatibility with the tables shown on the Zetlex website. You'll find these in the document section on the encoder part of the website. In this example, we'll go for the most frequent choice, SSI 1. The next element is the connector. There's a big range of options, including axial and radial connections, as well as integral cables. Again, the product guide shows you all the various details. Integral cable options are useful if your project has harsh conditions such as water, dirt, or aggressive vibration. If you need an extra long cable fitted, this is possible. Contact Zetlex for more information. If the encoder is to be used in mineral oil, you don't necessarily need an integral cable. All the connection options will work fine in mineral oil. In this example, we'll choose the most common choice, axial connector AC1. The next element is supply voltage. For operating environments with temperatures up to 105 Celsius, select the 5HT option. For low temperature applications down to minus 60, choose the 12CT or 24CT options. For analog voltage output, you'll need a 12 or 24 volt supply. In this example, we'll choose the most common supply, which is 12 volts, which actually covers a range of 4.5 to 32 volt DC supply. In the final element, the default selection is AN for the standard anodized surface finish. However, you can also add some extended range options. These aren't needed for most applications. They're usually for defense, aerospace, and special industrial applications. The options include ultra-high shock and vibration, thermal stress screen and bakeout, Surtec rather than anodized surface finish. This is for when a conductive surface finish is required. High operating pressures, leaded rather than unleaded solder, grade serial and part numbers, and conformally coated sensor faces. In this example, we'll not choose any extended range options. We'll simply select the default anodized surface finish. So there we are. We have a part number and a list price. You can either order online or generate a quote. If you order online, you can pay by credit card or just send us an order number using the pay offline function. Don't forget cables. These can be found on the accessories part of the website. Remember too that the prices on the website are just list prices. Discounts apply for quantities of more than 5 units. If you get stuck, give us a call or send an email to info@zetlex.com. Thanks for watching.